You ready?
Had my head.
What do you mean, had your fucking shut the puss? How's about that? I put Vaseline in your hair. I have to keep it out of the road.
Okay.
Right, here we go. Hey everybody, welcome to Nine Liner Tattoo. This is my wife, Mrs. MacDonald. I found this footage, I done tattooed this maybe last year or even the year before. A little snowflake on the side of the face. And yeah, I thought I'd put it in because the winter's coming up and stuff. And yeah, I thought it was pretty cool. So this is me tattooing Sarah on the face. If I remember right, this was super thin. This was maybe like a tight 7 or even a 5. Super fun. It's always nerve-wracking tattooing your other half. Doesn't matter who they are, family members, whatever. But tattooing your family member or your wife's face is a big deal. So I was a bit nervous, but it turned out super cool. Sarah's a really good customer when it comes to after the first 5 minutes. The first 5 minutes with any tattoo that I tattoo on Sarah, she gets... like, there's always usually tears, stress, and then she just completely settles it. Not with other people that tattoo her. I watched her getting her full back done with my old boss, and she never cried one time. She was fantastic. But with me, there's no barrier. But obviously, this time, there was no crying. There was just stress because it was on the face, and yeah, it turned out super fun. So, yeah, I hope you enjoy it. Right.
We're going to put a big rock. So we've knocked out for about 20 minutes, eh?
Right.
Then woke up, and then just couldn't have moved, I thought, eh? And I was like, well, nobody's about, you know what? Nobody's got to be about.
Aye.
I mean, on a Friday evening, eh?
And what had you done to yourself?
Broken hip and broke my arm in 5 places.
Broken hip and broke your arm in 5 places? Well, if you're going to date, you might as well date right. Aye, there's no point in just having a wee fucking splint or a chip out your knee or something. Aye. You want to fucking really hump your
thing. That's
Jesus Christ,
it's like,
man.
Like 130 staples on, eh? Fucking in a wheelchair, a lot, man.
You were in a wheelchair?
Aye.
How long were you in hospital?
I was in hospital 2.5 weeks in the Royal, eh? In that fucking, what do you call it?
Intensive care?
No, I don't know that one.
Nah. That's fucking mental, eh? That's a bad one. Well, there's not any good ones, but that's a particularly fucking bad one, isn't it?
Jeez,
oh.
The worst one yet, anyway.
Your worst one yet? Aye, there's still time to fuck yourself right up, eh?
Exactly.
Have some faith in yourself.
Aye.
You too can hump yourself to death. Fucking right. Dear me. So it's not put you off going on bikes then?
Well, Lorraine, she's still got her quad, eh? But every bumper hit, it's here on the air, I'm
so the pod's
looked up in the shed now.
How old's your little one?
She's 14 now, eh?
Fucking hell.
Aye, 15 no. Mixed in April, eh?
Not so little then, eh?
Aye. Well, she's like, oh, I'll come down and I'll get tattooed. No, you won't.
No, you won't.
I can sit and watch, aye, you're no 18.
The things they see when their parents do, eh?
That's it. Aye, she's determined for a tattoo, eh? You wait till you're 18.
I'll still be here, hopefully. Aye.
I
have a motorbike, so I should be good.
I thought you were shut down, eh?
No, man.
You say that you're only open a couple of days, eh?
I'm open Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. I'm trying that 4-day week thing.
Ah, right,
quite
right.
But my wife had cancer,
right,
and my dad's got cancer, so whenever something comes up, I just, you know, I don't give a shit about money or tattoo. I just go home, you know, I go and help, I'd go, you know. So, but aye, there's no point in, I was doing six sometimes, for a while I was doing 7 days a week, burning myself out, and there's no fucking point. I was getting really unhappy with it. And to be 44,
and wake up and then hate having to go. I thought I need to do something here because I'm going to ruin everything I've worked for, you know.
So well, I had been to. Here a while, wouldn't you?
Aye, 10 years. Aye. 10 years.
So in case you missed all of that, I tattooed this gentleman years ago, and then I didn't hear from him for quite a while. It turns out that he had a little bit of an issue with booze, like some people do, but he also had a problem with motorcycles. And by problem, I mean, also here you'll see that I set up my camera and my fucking big bald head got on the road. So there's no much footage of the lining for this one. I don't understand why I never bothered looking up at one point during the hour and a half, 2 hours it took. Anyway, I digress. So he'd sometimes go up the local bing, the local sort of abandoned place with his couple of bottles of wine, Buckfast or whatever it was, and his motorbike. And this time he happened to fall off his bike and injure himself. Now, he fell off his bike and he shattered his hip, which is bad, real bad. But then, from the elbow up, he broke his arm in 5 places. He had no phone, he had nobody with him. So with that broken arm, with that shattered hip, and with some injuries to the face and just averagely severe injuries, he dragged himself for what he could, between the two of us, we tried to come up, dragged himself for about half a mile to try and get some help. And obviously it did, because if not, he would definitely have died. And then he was in hospital for, like you said, 2.5 weeks, and he was in a wheelchair and he was absolutely twatted. And then he stopped drinking. Unfortunately, it was groundskeeping stuff. He can't do that anymore. So he's kind of fucked, but he's getting better. And also, I've just noticed that I've got a huge piece of Vaseline, or it'll be hustle butter, on the side of my beard there. You see it? That's fucking annoying, isn't it? Twat. Anyway, so I'm glad that he's better. And I also tattooed the front of his shin this day, but we only done lines because it was getting a bit nippy for him. So, but yeah, I mean, imagine that, shattered hip, not just a little crack or a break, shattered hip, broken your arm between the elbow and the shoulder in 5 different places, can't walk, can't foot, and then drag yourself for half a mile to try and find someone, like a main road nearby or something like that. Jeez, oh, that, I mean, nope, no thank you. So hats off to him for surviving that one, and for turning his life around and recognizing he doesn't drink. In this bit, he's telling me that he's got a 14-year-old daughter, 15, soon to be 15, who's got a quad bike, and he can't really go on that either because every bump he hits, it hurts his bones and stuff. So, but fair play to you, man. Fair play to you. So, next up is a lady called Kim. I tattoo her and her sister Amy, but I've tattooed Kim at least three times. You'll see poking out on the left-hand side of her thigh is a raven with an Edgar Allan Poe piece, which was super fun. For some reason, the footage of that, I think, is corrupt. The memory card that I used for that was obviously the same card that I used on her other tattoo, which was H.P. Lovecraft Cthulhu tattoo, which I really also enjoyed. That footage, I think, ballsed up somehow. And I used the same card to start the lining of this Jack the Ripper themed piece. And for some reason, the very beginning of it didn't work. So I've managed to repair some of the footage, but not all of it. But as you'll see, we're getting there. So enough moaning, enough negative. So this one we were discussing during either the Poe piece or the Cthulhu piece, about my obsessions that I've had since I was a little kid about Jack the Ripper. Jack the Ripper, the Michael Caine movie for TV that came in two parts. And then about 20 years ago, maybe 25 years ago, they gave it away with a local newspaper again. It is the best Jack the Ripper movie ever. I'm telling you now. The Johnny Depp one's dog shit, but the Michael Caine one from, I think, the late 80s, maybe early 90s, is absolutely incredible. I urge you to watch it. It's on for a long time, hence why they split it into two. But I digress. A long, long time ago, we're talking about 17, 18 years ago, when I was thinking about getting stuff on my sternum, I got a little bit of Jack the Ripper writing, which I'll show you in a second, just to test how sore the sternum was going to be for me to see if I could handle it. And turns out it was fucking horrifyingly painful, but I went through with it all anyway, and everybody's seen my torso many times. But I'll show you, actually, what I will do is I'll show you that little tiny bit of Jack the Ripper writing right now. So, turns out it was 15 years ago that I got this piece of writing done. You'll see it right in the middle there with my wee chesty hairs. And it was exactly 120 years to the day that Jack the Ripper sent the letter to Inspector Abilene, and he signed it from hell. So that's why I was doing reading, and I was just, you know, and watching stuff again, and I came in that day and I realised it was 120 years exactly to the day. So I got that tattoo done on the 16th of the 10th, 2008, which I thought was pretty cool. Anyway, it's not about me, it's about my customer. So back to Kim.
Getting further than the leg again,
yeah.
I do that every time. I'm great. I do that with
folks'
arms and the fucking everything.
So, on with the shading. All black and grey stuff with Kim. I don't know why. Just this one was super fun. And as you'll see at the end, there's the bag. Oh, as you can see now, there's the bag that says Jack's written on it, which is an old bag, hence the scuffs. Open up with some smoke coming out of it with Ripper written in it. What you might not be able to make out right now is that in his face is surgical tools that he may or may not, or definitely probably would have maybe had inside his bag. So I enjoyed this appointment because Kim and I both bounced back and forward what she thought who Jack might have been. Basically, we just sort of riffed back and forwards as to various, theories and whatever else, and it was a really fun experience, really fun tattoo, and yeah, she's a good customer, so thank you, buddy. I was literally just finishing up here the last few touches of the little surgical tools inside the face. I've done a series of stuff where I've done recognizable people, but inside the face I put the things that person might or might not be recognizable for, depending if you're in that, you know, that world sort of thing. And this was just one of the ideas. Well, we're doing the Cthulhu one, I think it was, the Poe one. And I told her about my obsession for Jack, and she says, could you come up with something for Jack? And straight away I was like, face, top hat, tools, bag. And it was this tattoo right now, within about 3 seconds, is exactly what I described to Kim. And it's exactly what I saw in my head as soon as she asked me. So I was quite pleased with that. So, yeah, I really did enjoy doing that, and it was a super fun tattoo. As you'll see in a second, it's the redness has sort of settled down a little bit. I have a green soap with a tea tree and stuff in it, a tea tree oil, which is what sort of helps settle it down, the redness a little bit. Kim self-admittedly does have super sensitive skin, so but yeah, still, I've seen it since it's healed. Or have I actually? I'm not quite sure. But she sent me a photograph, perhaps, and it's super settled in and really nice. But I really enjoyed this, so thank you very much. And I really hope you enjoyed this video, everybody. Please consider subscribing. It's nothing to you, but it's everything to me. So click the little button, and I'll see you next time. Peace.